This is part three of Parabolas, and we go over functions of the form f of x equals x minus h squared and graph the following four parabolas. Okay, let's start off by graphing the following three functions, which will be parabolas, on the same set of axes. So you want to get out a piece of graph paper. And to get started, what I did is why don't you use these values of x, and then plug them in to get x squared, and that'll be your order pairs that will be green for f of x equals x squared. Then plug in those values of x for x minus 1 squared. That will be your y values, your y coordinates for the second graph. And then plug in those values of x for the third one. So put the video on pause and just fill out the chart first. In fact, let's just do the x squared first and graph that one. Okay, we've been graphing f of x equals x squared or y equals x squared several times in the first two videos on parabolas. So these are the ones you want to basically always remember: negative 3, 9, negative 2, 4, negative 1, 1, etc. And we get this basic shape over here of the parabola. The vertex goes through 0, 0. It's going up. And the axis of symmetry is here at the y-axis at x equals 0. All right, now, how about doing the next two? X minus 1 squared and then x plus 2 squared. So go ahead and fill those in. All right, so if I'm going to do that, if I put in negative 3 for x into the blue, I'm going to get negative 4 squared. That's going to be 16. And then if I put in negative 2 for x, that'll be negative 3 squared, which is 9. If I put in negative 1, I'm going to get negative 2, the whole quantity squared, which is 4. If I put in 0, I get negative 1 squared, which is 1. If I put it 1, I get 0 squared, which is 0. Put in 2, I get 1 squared, which is 1. And if I put in 3, I get t squared is 4. You might notice a little shifting of the numbers here from the x squared, actually. So let's go ahead and plot those. Well, negative 3, 16, I can't get that on my graph. It's too far up there. So let's do negative 2, 9. So if I go over negative 2 and I go up 9, and then I go negative 1, 4. So go negative 1, 4. And we've got 0, 1 right here. And then 1, 0 will be right here. And then 2, 1. And then 3, 4. And that's all I have, but you could surmise this is going to be the next point up here. And notice that all the points on my green parabola here, for the blue one, it's 1 to the right. See how it went over 1 to the right? So interesting, when it was an x minus 1 in parentheses, it went over 1 to the right. And its axis of symmetry also shifted over 1 to the right. Okay, let's do x plus t squared. So we're going to put all these values of x in to the purple, the x plus 2. So I'm going to have negative 3 plus 1. That's a negative 1 squared, which is 1. Remember, when you square anything, it's going to be positive. When you put in negative 2, you get 0 squared, which is 0. If you put in negative 1, you get 1 squared, which is 1. When you put a 0, you get t squared, which is 4. When you put a 1 squared, you get 9. Put in 1, you get 3 squared, which is 9. When you put in a 2, you get 4 squared, is 16. Put a 3, you get... Okay, those are going to be too big to plot, but let's see what happens here. So this gives me the order pair negative 3, 1. Negative t, 0. Negative 1, 1. Lands on the same thing as this one. It was a little confusing here. 0, 4, 1, 9, 216 is too high. But hopefully you can see what's happening here. If you look at the original graph, the green graph, y equals x squared, it's two to the left. Remember, this was a green point here. I went two to the left. Here was a green point here, two to the left. Here was a green point here, two to the left. Here's a green point up here, two to the left. So I'm gonna guess that this is gonna go two to the left right here, and this to the left right here. And you could verify that by plugging in negative four for x, and you'll get two squ four squ I'm sorry, two squ negative two quantity squared will give you four. So here's my purple graph. So you see, they all have the same shape, and they're sort of just moving left and right. And what it depends on is, so if it's in this form, x minus or x plus something, if it's a minus one, it actually shifts to the right, opposite direction. Or you could think of, what number do you have to put in for x to make that a zero? In other words, solve for zero. X minus one is zero. X would be one. That tells you shift at one, positive one to the right. Now, for the next one, x plus two, when it was a plus two, notice it shifted to the left. In other words, to make what's in the parentheses zero, right, x plus two equals zero, x would be negative two. That helps you remember, shift two to the left. You don't have to memorize that because you could just plug in a bunch of ordered pairs like we did here. So let's summarize this. All right, if we're graphing a parabola of the form f of x equals, in parentheses, x minus h squared. Now notice there's a minus sign in front of the h. So if you had x plus 3, you could think of that as x minus a negative 3. So if h is positive, so if you had something like x minus 3, then the graph is shifted 8 units to the right. So if it was x minus 3, it would be 3 units to the right. If h is negative, like x minus a negative 2, which you would read as x plus 2, then the graph of y equals x squared is shifted 2 units to the left. So when you see a plus, a positive number, remember you're really going to go to the left that many units. The vertex is h0, and the axis symmetry is x equals h. Anytime you have the vertex, whatever the x coordinate is, that will be what goes for the axis symmetry, what x is equal. X equals to the same number as the x coordinate of the vertex. So we'll look again at the graphs we just did. The vertex for the purple one, the graph, is going to be negative 2, 0. And the axis symmetry right here was the line x equals negative 2, for instance. So if you look at that, x plus 2 squared, since it's an x plus 2, the graph got shifted to the left 2 spaces. Okay. And an easy way to get the axis of symmetry, by the way, is to take what's in parentheses and set it equal to 0. So if you did x plus 2 equals 0, you get x equals negative 2. So that's another way of getting it. All right, and then you could also verify for the blue one, this is 1, 0, and the axis symmetry is x equals 1. Again, if you took the equation x minus 1 equals 0 and solved it, you would get this x equals 1, and then you know that same number 1 is what goes in for the vertex. Right, so now let's just graph one more. So graph f of x equals x plus 1 squared. You can make a table, or you could think of just shifting the graph. So put the video on pause and try that on your own. All right, here's how I do it. I figure out the axis of symmetry, and that's the other thing I wanted you to do. The axis of symmetry and the vertex right away. So the axis of symmetry, if you set x plus 1 equals 0, that's x equals negative 1, which means the vertex has to be negative one something. And when you put in negative one, you'll get 0 for f of x, right? Because you get 0 squared. So I plot that point. I draw my axis of symmetry. And then I pretend that's like my 0, 0. Okay, this is how I do it. I pretend like that's my 0, and I do the basic parabola. Over 1 and up 1, over 2 and up 4, over 3 and up 9, and I do points on the opposite side because this is symmetric. Right? If there's 3 to the right, there's 3 to the left, and that's the quick way to graph it without making all those ordered pairs. Now, of course, if you make a chart of ordered pairs, your graph should look exactly the same as mine.